Meanwhile, under the stands, getting ready for the opening of the 400 meters, it'll be Jeremy Warner who will begin the long process of defending his Olympic gold medal. Oregon and the track and field Olympic trials. Jeremy Warner, the world champion and Olympic gold medalist at 400 meters under the stadium. He'll be on the track shortly. But first, the opening heat of the men's 400 meter dash. The top three in each heat plus the next four best times overall will advance. And in this first heat is LaShawn Merritt, the silver medalist at the World Championships in Osaka last summer, who had a big win earlier this year over Jeremy Warner, the man who beat him at the Worlds in Osaka.
And Tom, when we talked, LaShawn Merritt kept that win in perspective. He said it was important for him psychologically to defeat the Olympic champion, but he realizes that he has to repeat that performance and move forward here, get to the final, and try and do that same thing in the final to make the team.
As you see, LaShawn Merritt is in lane four.
And as much talent as track and field has lost to football, it's good that we got this one. Former football player decided to quit football, and here he is, silver medalist from last year's World Championships.
There's the gun, and LaShawn Merritt in his opening round heat in the men's 400. Again, the top three finishers automatically advance, plus the next four fastest.
LaShawn Merritt has the best 200-meter speed of all the quarter milers, and that's the reason why you see him taking command right now down the back stretch.
Merritt in the center of the track, lane four, and running easily right now. And looks to be in command of the race. LaGerald Betters is also running pretty well, just to his inside. Coming to the top of the home straightaway, and LaShawn Merritt leading this heat in the 400. Merritt in the center of the track, running easily still. Miles Smith is coming along, and LaGerald Betters right behind LaShawn Merritt. So LaShawn Merritt, an easy time of it in his opening race in the 400 meters. Betters finishing
Merritt
second.
45-30.
It appeared right behind him.
And Merritt had a great series of runs going back to March all the way up into these Olympic trials, and you can just see the ease that he crosses the finish line with, which says that he is in perfect condition for this, for what's happening here at the Olympic trials.
He's with Bob Neumeyer.
All right, LaShawn, your priorities now for these trials.
Oh, man. To have a good first race.
Which you did.
What if I say good for the first race?
How badly do you want to be Jeremy Warner in these trials?
That's not as important as the Olympic Games. You know, had an easy first race. Getting ready for the semifinal.
See you a little later.
VA.
Next on the track, Jeremy Warner in his opening heat in the men's 400-meter dash. Jeremy has just dominated the 400 meters. He won the gold medal in Athens. He won the gold medal at the last two World Championships, 205, 2005, and 2007. Here he is in Athens leading the U.S. suite.
And Jeremy Warner told me that as he finished this race and won his first Olympic title, it really didn't sink in until he was standing on the podium and he had the medal around his neck and they played the national anthem for him, and that's when he realized what he had accomplished. And so now, 4 years later, he stands in this great stadium hoping for another opportunity and now to defend that Olympic gold medal.
He's in the outside lane in lane eight, and he raised some eyebrows early this year when he parted ways with his longtime coach Clyde Hart, who had coached Michael Johnson as well, now coached by Baylor assistant Michael Ford. And shortly after that, he was defeated by LaShawn Merritt in Berlin, so the lips started wagging, but he came back and ran 43.98 after being defeated the following week in Oslo, the fastest time in the world this year.
And Tom, quite honestly, the only time you can really question that decision is if he does not defend in Beijing, because a loss during the season is one thing, but if he loses that title, I think that decision will really be second-guessed.
You know, when I talked to Jeremy about this decision, he said he thought it was the right decision for him. He wasn't quite sure how long Clyde Hart, his previous coach, and of course the man who took Michael Johnson to greatness, how much longer Hart would be coaching. Michael Ford had been an assistant with Hart for 8 years, and so he knew the exact system that Warner was training under, and so he felt like the decision to change would be okay and work out for him.
And like his mentor, Michael Johnson, this is a young man who was not heavily recruited coming out of high school. So you high schoolers out there, you don't have to be all world coming out of high school, because look at the meteoric rise of Jeremy Warner. Went to Baylor as a relay athlete, and he's become Olympic and world champion several times over now. The most dominant 400-meter runner since Michael Johnson.
He draws lane 8 here, which means that he won't be able to see any of his competitors. That shouldn't matter to him, though, should it?
No, and the glasses will help him also, because he wears those for focus.
And on their way, Jeremy Warner in the outside lane, the defending Olympic gold medalist and world champion at 400 meters.
And even though he's not coached by Clyde Hart anymore, the Clyde Hart system is we stick to our script. And right now you see him losing a little bit of ground, but he's probably been instructed, do not run until you get to about 150 meters out, and I think that's what he's going to do right now.
David Neville off to a good start as they round the final turn and come to the home straightaway, and Jeremy Warner is in front. David Neville is in there in second place. And on the outside lane, here comes Jeremy Warner, crowd appreciating him. He'll come to the line. It'll be Neville second, and actually Hertel gets second, and then Neville dropping back to third right at the finish. Jeremy Warner with a little walk in the park.
And we have Jeremy Warner with us. Jeremy, coming in, personal bests, records, just make the team. What are you working on?
Just make the team right now. Make it to the final. Had lane 8, so didn't get out like I wanted to, but I made up for it. Was able to shut it down, so I felt good.
Some eyebrows were raised when Merritt Beach in Germany. Is there any payback here for you in these trials over here?
No payback. Just want to go out there and run my race and win and make the team.
Okay, Jeremy.
Thank you.
Tom?
Sounds like a simple formula. And, of course, Angelo Taylor, well, we saw him, it seemed like, just a minute ago when he finished third in the 400-meter hurdles. In fact, he had to out-lean Gaiman at the wire just to advance here. 1, 2, 3, Angelo Taylor. And now here he is right back on the track for the opening heat in the open 400 meters. You started to watch on him there, Lewis, when he finished the 400 hurdles. How long has he been away?
Not long, and I'm sure for him not long enough. So far my watch reads 20 minutes and 35, 36, 37 seconds. That's not much time.
And Lewis, I can tell you, I did a couple doubles in my own career.
Right.
That is not enough for a 100, 200 double. I can't imagine what he's feeling like after having to lean for that tape to get third place, and now here he is, not half hour later.
Well, he trusts his fitness, and we talked about this yesterday, again, the big why question, why do it? He said that no one knew he was trying to pull off this double. He started working on it 2 years ago. He actually doubled at the Grand Prix final last year in Stuttgart, Germany, where he finished fifth in the 400 hurdles, and 50 minutes later, he came back and ran the quarter, finishing in 44.94. But to have only 20 minutes between the two after having worked so hard to make the team, I'm curious to see what happens here.
Angelo in lane 3, and you might have done a double take as you looked at lane 2 there when it said Calvin Smith. It's Calvin Smith Jr., son of the two-time world champion at 200 meters.
And out in lane 8, Jordan Bowes. Very talented youngster from University of Washington.
Angelo Taylor wants to buy a few more minutes.
Let me restart my watch here.
That's a brilliant move. You take your false start,
that's
that gives
right.
him another 2 minutes. And that, ladies and gentlemen, this is how you buy yourself 2 or 3 more minutes to recover. That's actually a veteran move
that's
there.
That's right.
And in the quarter mile, it's not that important.
Now, I just wonder if he'll admit that to Bob Newmar after the race is over.
A little gamesmanship from the former Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, the Olympic gold medalist in Sydney in the 400 hurdles, getting a couple more minutes to catch his breath.
And remember, he doesn't have to win this heat. Jordan Bowes, I think, is going to lead out of lane 8. He's very fresh. Tyree Washington also in there in lane 6. All Angelo has to do is get in the top 3, and if not, even the next 4 best times, although he won't want to leave it to that. As long as he's in the top 3, he will qualify out of this heat.
There's Tyree Washington.
Tyree Washington, of course, 2-time medalist at the World Championships, bronze in 97, silver in 03. But this would be his first Olympic team should he make it on this team to Beijing.
And Angelo Taylor has examined the Olympic Games schedule and said that he believes that the 400 hurdle 400 double is possible. He's going to have to get through this first round, and Otto, like you said, being safely in the top three to make sure he advances to the next round.
Let's talk a little history. If he should pull that off in Beijing, no man has ever done that.
Right.
He's already earned a ticket to China as a member of the 400-meter hurdle team. And this is a fair start. And Bowes from the University of Washington out in lane eight. Angelo Taylor trying to gut it out. He's in lane three.
And I think he has an advantage, Taylor does, being back in lane three because he can see the field. But right now, the field is leaving him.
Angelo Taylor really struggling down the backstretch. And you have to think, he is not recovered, guys. It simply was not enough time in between those rounds. He is out of this race at this point.
Tyree Washington, Drew Marano from Colorado State, Bowes from Washington.
Taylor dropped out.
Taylor is out of the race. So Angelo Taylor was just too much. So here they come out of the straightaway with Blakely, Englehart, Summers, Washington. And crossing the line, it will be Engelbert Summers from Baylor University. And Angelo Taylor dropping out of the race. It was just too much, and it was obvious. Once they got onto the back stretch that he was not going to be able to make it.
In real early, Tom, because his body just did not respond. Angelo Taylor here in the blue on the right of your screen, and already everyone has left him, and now he's beginning to think, what am I doing? Thinking about the pain. The lactic acid from the final of that 400 hurdle has not drained out of his legs. Just couldn't do it.